गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी डूइंग प्रेपरेशन ऑफ कोलोइडल सॉल्ट्स. ओके, नाउ विच टाइप ऑफ कोलोइडल सॉल्ट्स वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट? ऑब्वियसली वी हैव टू लर्न प्रेपरेशन ऑफ लायोफोबिक कोलोइडल सॉल्ट. व्हाई? बिकॉज लायोफोबिक कोलोइडल सॉल्ट्स कैन नॉट बी प्रिपेयर्ड ईजिली. Because the phase and the medium, the dispersed phase and the medium do not like each other. That is the reason. So, phyllic can be prepared very easily. You just mix the phase with the medium, they can be prepared easily. So, we will be studying preparation of lyophobic colloidal salts. Okay, in that preparation, we are taking the first one as Brydig arc method. Brydig arc method, which is also called as electrical dispersion method. It is also called electrical dispersion method. Now, in this electrical dispersion method, what we do? See, there is one outer container, you can see here. In this outer container, there are ice cubes. There are ice cube because you have to keep this cool. Now, actually, before we begin this, let me tell you the lyophobic colloidal salt examples are metal salts, because we will be preparing metal salts by Brydig arc method. Which metal salts we are talking about? Copper, silver, gold, platinum. These salts we can prepare, but you cannot even imagine, you know, these metals we can dissolve in water. But now we can prepare by using Brydig arc method, or also called as electrical dispersion method. So now what is done? There is outer container in which we take ice. There is one beaker kept inside. In the beaker there is solvent taken. The solvent which we take here is water. We take water in this container. Okay, and now what we do is the two electrodes are immersed in this. What electrodes we have taken here? It can be any of these. That can be gold, silver, platinum, copper, any metal whose salt we want to prepare will be taken. And these are then connected to high voltage is applied to them. So when high voltage is applied to them, that is an electric arc is struck between the electrodes, tremendous heat is generated. So much heat is generated such that these metals, you know, they vaporize. When they vaporize, since outside you have ice, as soon as these vapors come out, they condense. So what is happening, children? Is it clear? So first what we have done is the electric arc is struck between the electrodes, which results in the heat generation, which vaporizes these metal salts. As these vapors come out, they immediately condense because outside there is ice and this water is cold, and the solution what you prepare here is called as the metal salt of whatever metal we have considered. Is this clear? This is first example we have taken, lyophobic colloidal salts of metal salt category prepared by Brydig arc method. Okay, now we will be talking about the second method, which is also quite important. That method is called as peptization. It is peptization. Now, first we will write what is the definition of peptization. Now, peptization is a process. It is a process of converting. Process of converting freshly prepared precipitate into colloidal form. into colloidal form by adding suitable electrolyte. By adding suitable electrolyte. Maybe, you know, if I say, did you follow anything? You must have not followed anything. By adding suitable electrolyte. You may not have followed anything. Now, what exactly we do? We will take example. So, in this, the freshly prepared precipitate. Precipitate, children, what is precipitate? It is something which has settled down. This, if we can bring back into the colloidal solution form by adding some electrolyte, that is called as peptization. Freshly prepared precipitate converted to colloidal sol by adding an electrolyte is called as peptization. Now, how we do that? Let us take that example. See, children, you have studied in salt analysis ki Fe lies in third group. You get precipitate of ferric hydroxide precipitate you have. It is a precipitate, PPT. Now, suppose you take what is basically a PPT. I hope you have an idea. If you take a test tube, in that what is settled down, this is called as a precipitate. Suppose you have this ferric hydroxide precipitate. How can you convert this precipitate back into the colloidal form? That we are discussing. So what happens here is, suppose to this ferric hydroxide, if we add ferric chloride, then on this ferric hydroxide, this ferric ions, why ferric ions? Between the PPT and the electrolyte, what is common? Ferric ion. What is common will get adsorbed preferentially on the surface of this. Okay, so let us continue further here. So let me draw this figure and explain. Suppose you have this ferric hydroxide precipitate, right? It's a ferric hydroxide precipitate. This is the precipitate. If you add on this ferric ion, okay, what will happen? You will have number of ferric hydroxides like this. You will have number of ferric on these ferric Fe3 plus from ferric chloride, from the electrolyte, gets adsorbed. So another ferric hydroxide might be there. Many molecules of ferric hydroxide might be there. On each one of them, number of the ferric ions, not just one, many ferric ions get adsorbed. There is one another term we have done in this chapter of surface chemistry, adsorb. So it is basically preferential adsorption of one of the ion which is common between the electrolyte and the precipitate. So once this is adsorbed onto it, what will happen? All these ferric ions are having positive charge. When they have positive charge, means like charges, that depends. In some cases you might have negative charge, but in this case it is positive. So they all will repel. This positive will repel. So what will happen? These will get dispersed into the test tube. So what will happen now? This will result in the formation of a colloidal sol. You will have a colloidal sol prepared. Is it clear? This is one example we have considered. One example. Okay. You can have another example. See, you can have another example of, you know, you have silver nitrate test. That is, for chloride ion, you get a silver chloride precipitate. To that silver chloride precipitate, if you add silver nitrate, excess silver nitrate if you're adding, what will happen? On this, silver ions will get adsorbed. So you will have AgCl on it. Ag plus getting adsorbed, and it will result in the formation of colloidal. I am using CS for colloidal solution. What is AgCl? It is a precipitate. What is this? Electrolyte. It is electrolyte. From the electrolyte, Ag, which was common with AgCl, is adsorbed onto the surface and you get colloidal solution. This process is peptization. Is this clear? So we have discussed two methods for preparing. One we have discussed in the beginning was Brydig's arc method to prepare lyophobic. I told you why phobic is preferred, because it is not easy to prepare phobic colloidal salts. Phyllic you can prepare very easily by dissolving just a dispersed phase in dispersed medium. So one method for metal salts, you take metal salts, this is ice in it, there is water, electric arc is struck between the two, these vaporize. As soon as they vaporize, because of ice, it condenses, it results in the formation of colloidal salt. Second example, children, we have considered is peptization. What we considered, what is peptization? Here I told you it is a process of converting precipitate into colloidal solution by addition of suitable electrolyte, not any electrolyte, suitable. So I have considered two examples in this. Number one was ferric hydroxide plus ferric chloride. On the precipitate, common ion was adsorbed, preferentially adsorbed, because all positive ions are surrounding ferric hydroxide. So what will happen? They will all will repel. This is also, you know, one of the reason for colloidal solutions being stable. They are stable, they are not getting precipitated, not getting coagulated. Okay, they all remain dispersed out in the solution. So colloidal solution is prepared. Another example I have considered was silver chloride with silver nitrate, where silver is getting adsorbed on AgCl precipitate. You get positively charged colloidal salt. Whatever charge is getting adsorbed on the precipitate, that will be the charge of the colloidal salt. We will be talking about this in the next videos, that colloidal solutions have charge on them. Clear? I hope you have followed this. Okay.